Good evening, everybody, and welcome back. Sam here at Sammy J Stitches, and today I have with me.
Jessie from Jessie Maria Does Stuff.
And we are very fortunate that we actually have the creator of the tag we are going to work on today, except that I kind of tweaked it a little bit, but it was Jessie's original tag. In fact, a couple years ago, we did the tag together.
We did the whole thing.
The whole thing.
Yeah.
And when I was looking back through it, I was like, okay, so some of this, it's a bit much. So
Yeah.
we're just going to focus on our favorites of things. So we're going to get started. And what is your favorite whip from this year?
My favorite whip. Well, so I pulled my favorite whip, but I haven't been able to work on it this year. And I
It's
think
still
that's probably
a whip.
Yeah. And it's that's probably why it's my favorite, because I miss it so much. But it is my Chatelaine Poison Garden.
Yes, I love that one.
Yeah, it's sparkle, sparkle.
I feel like I hadn't seen it in a while. I was like, it did finish it and I missed it.
Yeah, I wish I finished it, but no, I have a long way to go. It's gonna need this whole piece of fabric.
Oh wow.
It's gonna need all of this. So yeah. So this is one of the ones that I'm gonna try to work on pretty early in the new year.
Do you have any specific goals for it?
No, just work on it. For the first time in over a year.
All
I'm trying
right.
to do a little less of that specific old stuff and more generic stuff. So
yeah, I found like over the last year I've become more and more like generalized goals.
Less of a box to try to fit in.
Right. Okay, so my favorite for you is Give Thanks. And
Thanks.
I'm not sure I've seen you work on this recently, though.
I did work on it recently. I worked on it in November. Go figure. And it's here.
I'm not used to all this daylight. Like, I was not prepared.
All right. So that lives in a bag. And yeah, I worked on this for about 10 minutes in November. I had it set up in my frame wrong, and so it was loosey-goosey, but
it's so pretty. So very fall.
It is very fall. So that's what it looks like now. And I have the cover here.
Yes.
Right there. So, yeah.
Very nice.
That's me. Okay, what about you? What's your favorite whip from this year of yours?
Oh, I wasn't prepared for that.
Whoa. Uh-oh.
Yeah. That's a good question. Like, it's like when, if you're not prepared for it, you just forget everything that you have. Oh,
Right.
I know. Not that I know where it is right now, but my little Stitch Girl, the Christmas one, the Gift of Giving. Like,
oh yeah,
I started it in November, and I just did not want to put it down. It's a really good one. It's really good. I like it. And your favorite for me?
Yeah, I told you what it was, and now I can't remember.
You said Garden Prelude.
Garden Prelude, yes. Even though it's stressing me out.
Why?
Your Garden Prelude stresses me out.
Is it that close to the bottom?
Yeah. Gosh, but that fabric is insanely perfect.
Right? And it's one of those things where, like, I had no control over how much green I would have. So, and I had no clue when I ordered it whether or not it would work. And so I just had to take a chance. And it's there.
Yeah.
It's
just a little tight, but it'll be all right. It'll be okay.
Yeah, so this one
so
is
good.
You know, I kind of do, you did it 1 year, where I'll pick one of my projects from each designer and have it in my main, what I'm going to work on. And then once I hit my goal on it, then I switch it out. So I'm doing Garden Prelude over like Miss Christmas Eve. So it will be seen very soon next year.
Yes.
All right. Next is your favorite finish.
Oh, this is impossible. This is impossible. This was almost harder for me than picking my favorite whip, because I have two very different styles here. my first big reproduction sampler, Leah Gronau, and it's the fabric for me on this one. But then I love my August quilt. I love this. It's so much fun. Super difficult, but so much fun.
Yeah. I started a pull of on one time and I ended up having to restart it three different times before I went, this is not for me.
Never mind. Yeah. I really enjoyed this. And it finishing looks so it good. Was yeah. So it's a toss up. And then your favorite of my finishes was also a contender for me, of course.
Right. And I was almost there for a second, like, did we pick the same one? Because
yeah. Well, I intentionally tried to go for some variation here. So
right. So my favorite of Jessie's is Bluebeard's Princess, which she just wrapped up.
Yep.
But it's just gorgeous. Ooh. I think it's the sea dragons for me, honestly.
Right? Like, they're so cool.
They are. The colors.
It's these beads. It's these beads in here. And sparkle. And her hair. Not gonna lie. Purple hair. Oh, yeah.
And she doesn't have any super awkward body parts.
No. Her bicep is a little weird, but nothing too crazy. So
that one that came out last month, was it Mantis? Her arms were all like super and I just couldn't get past it.
Yeah. What were you thinking, Nora?
I think there was an idea of like maybe how she was holding her dress. It didn't work. Whatever.
No.
So, I do not have Lady of the Flag finished yet. I had to order beads.
Oh no.
Well, I got leftover beads from a friend, and I didn't even think, let's check and see how many there actually are. And so I started stitching and I'm like, oh yeah, we're going to need more of these. So they've already shipped. They'll be here next week.
Okay.
So Jessie's, and my favorite finish, it's probably got to be Shores. We're going to share.
We'll be on the same page on that one.
Yeah. But I think part of that is because of the sentimentality of it. So I don't have it because I gave it to my mother-in-law, but here is what it looked like.
Oh, it's so cool.
So I did not do the whole piece. No. I only did certain parts. And it's because lighthouses are her favorite. As soon as I saw the lighthouse, I said, I'm stitching this one and I'm stitching it for my mother-in-law. But it was so big. And then after her dad passed away, I realized, and he was a naval frogman. So I realized that I could use certain pieces to represent not only him, but like her missing him, because it does says, I will wait for thee and that sort of thing. So, and that's her with it. She really liked it. So
that's so cool.
And it was an FFO this year. Cause you know,
right. I have to do those. Girl, you're beating me by about like two.
Did you have any FFOs this year?
No.
None. Okay. I know. We still got, was it Lady of the Flag sitting there waiting to go to,
and in this moment,
Erin Winslow. In this moment, yes. Yeah. You're like, I'm going to ship it. I'm going to ship it someday.
Yeah. Yeah. Every day I'm like, I need to ship this today. No, I need to ship this today. I needed to ship this a year ago.
But I can understand, you know, like,
yeah, it's hard.
All right. And your favorite new start.
Okay. My favorite of my new starts this year is one that I keep thinking about. So currently I'm doing this parade every day of my new starts. So each day is a new project that I have started this year. And this one, I can't wait to get to. It's coming up on Sunday. I'm so excited. And it's the dinkiest little start. Do you even know what that is?
I cannot tell.
It's Ragnarok from Long Dog Samplers.
I should have recognized the fabric.
Yeah, it's the fabric for me. So yeah, I'm so excited to get back to this on Sunday and hopefully lots next year.
Right.
Yeah.
Well, and I mean, it's monochromatic, so you should see it at least twice next year.
Yeah. And it lives in one of my favorite Bic bags.
That is gorgeous. I don't think I've ever seen that. And I like live on her page.
This was a birthday gift bag.
It's so cool.
Very cool.
I do have to admit, I was a little surprised with your plan to work on something new every day. One, because this is like a super busy time of year, so trying to do that is hard enough. And then you do not like changing projects that much.
Don't like to do it.
Are you changing it on your frame or just your QSAP?
On my frame.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So like every night you got to get down there and.
Yeah, every night I gotta shimmy on down to the floor and switch projects.
Because if you don't, you won't work on it.
Yeah. So a couple of them are gonna go in the QSnap. So just to make my life a little easier, like tomorrow's project is gonna go in the QSnap because we're traveling tomorrow. So
yeah.
So
it's the holidays. And that was another thing. I'm like, it's hard enough for you, but then to be in a time where you're so probably so super busy.
Yeah. Yeah, I had this grand idea that I was going to get 500 stitches a day on each of these projects, and that reality check hit me really hard in the face. Yeah. Just aim for 200, 300 if you're lucky. Right.
Just aim to stitch on it because I felt like I kind of had to do that too. I had a lot of expectations for December. I wanted to get all my categories in with, like, I think I put like 500 stitches in each, and then all my finishes. And then I just don't get as much time in December as I would really like to. So I was like, let's just focus on the finishing.
And it's the 23rd already. Like, what even is time?
I know. Luckily, I had two of my finishes last night, so that helped, but I still got a few more.
Yeah.
Okay. And
your favorite of my starts.
Yes. Snow day.
My snow day stitch. Just recently got some love. And ta-da.
I actually think I might have this pattern. Maybe that was my favorite. I think I bought the pattern, but I have not started it.
Well, that's a lot of white. It's a lot of white. And look, that's like six rows of like 200 stitches, just back and forth.
Solid.
So I started this one in a weird corner for me, but I'm liking it because I can kind of chunk it up a little bit as I work my way to the other side.
Right.
So
pretty. And that's a Shannon Christine, right?
Yeah, Shannon Christine.
Yeah.
Yep. She did a couple that are kind of like this. But this one, like, I was like, I have to start I need to stitch that. I need that. And this fabric is never going to show up right, but
it's still gorgeous. Like, and it works so well with the white.
Yeah.
At least your white's not just like disappearing on it.
No.
And you were working on that one specifically on days when it would snow. Am I correct?
Yeah. Yeah. That was the plan, was to just work on it on snow days. I ended up giving it some extra time because we don't get a whole lot of snow days. Right. The snow that we got in January was a lot, but not many days of it. So it got some extra time.
Too bad you can't stitch as quickly as it snows. Like,
right.
If it snows fast more, I can stitch faster. Right.
Yeah.
Okay. And your favorite of my starts this year?
Yeah,
is Moonlight Sampler from Moonlight the Blue Flower. And
because this is one of our in common ones.
Yeah, because which I didn't even know. We did not start this together. You actually have yours was started a while ago. So here's where I've gotten to.
Oh,
it's so
good. Yeah. Like,
that little hedgehog.
The hedgehog.
Everything. And
And the kiwi too.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, and the sloth, but we're just not seeing very much of him just yet. But And it's so delicate and dainty on this 40 count. Just, I love it.
I started that for Thor's birthday last year because
Okay.
it's got the girl swinging on the thing with the dog, and
And
so.
I didn't realize that, and like I hadn't really looked at the piece until somebody bought it from my shop, and then I went, "Hey,
I think I like
might
that.
need that." Yeah, like running a shop is probably the worst thing for my pocketbook. Like I have to have it all. So I'll order like whatever somebody requests plus a couple, and if they don't all sell well. All
You know,
right.
a stash in need.
Right. Now I got to pull up the next few questions because you answer them and I don't.
Hold on, what's your favorite of your starts?
Oh, my favorite. Probably that little Stitch girl, because I'm telling you, like I was so obsessed with it, like putting it down after 1500 stitches was really hard. And I think, well, I would like to say it's going to stitch up pretty quickly because the words do, but there's some pretty solid characters down there at the
There's a
bottom
lot in that.
that I haven't gotten to yet.
Yeah.
All right. So, how many whips did you start this year with?
83.
Wow. I don't think I
83.
realized you had so many. I thought you were.
A
What are
lot.
you at now?
Currently 76, but I'll be at 77 by the end of the year. Because I have one more new start and no more finishes. It's just not going to happen. How about
Okay.
you?
And how many? Okay. Actually, I think I might be ending the year with as many as I started the year with, which is 49. But part of that is because I've UFO'd
I did, yeah.
5 projects. And they're not, it's not that I'm not gonna work on them anymore. It's that we're just not gonna focus on them because I would like, because they're my full coverages, and I would like to focus on the 4 that I pulled for the year versus trying to get a little bit in all 8 of them.
I got you.
Because you know I can't like let a project just not be touched all year if it's on my whip list. So I
Right.
have to completely take it off my whip list and be like, these don't exist. Just a little bit. So yeah, I think I'm gonna be right around the same number. Like I'm trying to get a few more finishes, so I'm not positive just yet. But I started the year with 49, and I think I'll be ending close to that.
Pretty cool.
How
We're
many
close to
starts did you have this year?
that. Where is it? Where is it? Where is it? There it is. I had so far 12, but will be 13.
Okay, what are you starting? Like, can't keep teasing
Right, fine, I'll tell you.
it.
So you know Key and Pam from Just Keep Stitching, they do their New Year's Eve 12 by 12. I'm gonna start a year at Hockerin Hollow. And I'm going to do a block every hour. I'm going to work on a block every hour. It may just end up being us stranded into the border of each of the blocks every hour, but nonetheless.
Oh, that's a
Yeah.
fun. My alarm to wake up and go to work is going off.
Oh.
Yeah, that's fun. I think that's a neat idea, especially because not everyone wants to start 12 projects in 12 hours.
Yeah.
So it's a way of having new starts without having to have new starts.
Yep.
Let's see. I knew this number and then I don't know this number. 3, 6. 19 new starts?
That's impressive.
Yeah. Well, I mean, for the most part, I was going for one a month. And then in November, I just went a little crazy because, you
That one
know,
weekend.
yeah. But to be ending my year around the same number and have that many,
Right. Right. That's what I was saying is impressive to have that
pretty
many
good.
new starts and still be hanging out around the same number. That's cool.
But you know, my plan was to get down to 30.
Well, yeah.
I'm gonna need another couple years and no new starts if I'm gonna do that because I have like no smalls on my list anymore. None.
You would have done it if you started nothing.
Okay. Now I've lost my list. Where are we at? How many finishes did you have this
I should know that because it was exciting. 14.
That is good.
Yeah.
You feel
Twice
like
as
it's
many
been
as
a
I got last year.
right. That's what I was about to ask. You feel like it's been a little while since you were that prolific in your finishing.
But I'm also at the same spot. I have no smalls left. Like,
Yeah, and that's my problem too.
it's gonna
It's
take a
like
while.
I do this finish this stitch December, and the last couple of years I was finishing between 25 and 30 in the month of December, and then this month we're looking at like 7 because everything's just bigger. And I really need to start some more small stuff. I think I'm looking at currently I have 14 finished this year.
Twins.
And I definitely have at least one more finish, but three planned. I'm in October on temperature butterflies, so I'm really hoping to catch up. But like you said, it's the 23rd. So then I'm like, can I do it? Can I do it? My hummingbirds stitches up pretty quick and is close to a finish. And then of course, Lady of the Flag. And Lady of the Flag is going to depend on if the beads get here in time. I'm hoping so. Like I said, they shipped yesterday. I'm thinking maybe Wednesday or Thursday with the holidays because it's coming like 4 hours away. I was so tempted to be like, can I just drive to Dallas real quick? Just
Right,
real
just go scoop them up.
quick. They have that option now. You can pick up, which is cool.
Right. Is that 1, 2, 3? Yeah, and since now they're in Texas, like that's the option.
5 hour drive. Yeah. Okay. How many did you UFO?
Quite a few.
And are they like gone? Because like mine are not gone.
Yeah, I yeah, I guess it was only five, which is kind of that's not bad, considering years past. I don't do the like the mental gone. I do the like we're gonna unkit this,
I have
'cause
such a hard time with that. I've done it a few times in my stitchy career, but it has to be pretty extreme because I don't like to give up something I've already put up time into, you know?
I know, but I had reasons, like, and they're usually, I hate my stitches. For whatever reason, my stitches don't sit pretty enough for me, because so yeah, that's was the all five of them were like that.
I started watching a new floss tuber yesterday, and I recommended the floss tuber to a friend, and the friend goes, I already hate her. Her stitches are too perfect.
No.
And I'm over here like if there are stitches in the fabric, I'm good. Like
It looks like an X, and it might be looking in the same direction as the other one.
And no account for my backs. Like the back of Aberdeen
Oh,
is
yeah,
so
no.
bad. I was looking at it last night. I was like, this is just ridiculous. But
You
we're
showed it to us on Flosstube. It
gonna.
was like, you go, girl. You're so brave.
Gave no F's on this one. But it's just everything is so far from each other, and I'm not really good at the stopping and starting constantly.
Hate it.
I would never touch it again if I had to stop that much.
I agree. I'm the same way. I won't stitch it if it's got to be like that.
Yeah.
So.
Okay, did you achieve whichever goals you set for yourself this year?
No. Do I ever? Yeah. I always reach for the stars, and girl can't even reach the ceiling. Like, I wanted to put in, I think it was like at least 1,000 stitches on everything, but then I had it tiered, so I wanted my older things to get more stitches. I think I only worked on 45 of my 80 some odd projects. Let's see, what else did I want? I wanted to black out all of my WIPCO boards. Not a single one. I did not black out. I did finish more than I started. So
Okay.
I'll take it. I'll take it. I did
But
not
not two
finish.
to one.
It's not 2 to 1. No.
That was a thing at one point.
It was a thing. Really, my ultimate goal is to finish 10 more projects than I start. Mm-hmm. And I don't know if that's ever going to happen. I really don't think it's ever going to happen, but that's okay.
Maybe if you have a new start year, but man, that's
much impossible. Pressure. Yeah. It's really just impossible.
It's so much.
There's just pressure. So much good. And there's so much good stuff that comes out. Like, mm-hmm. like why wait?
Yeah.
What's the point?
And we have another friend. She did no new starts last year. And I'm telling you, it killed her stitchy butt. She was constantly just not working on anything. And then this year she allowed herself to start stuff and she's been stitching so much better. So it's not always the feasible option.
Right.
To just not start. There needs to
be some kind of a balance. Like maybe it's not a new start every day kind of thing, but.
Well, and that's, like I said, I did try and limit myself to like one a month this mm-hmm. year. And then I had a few more, but it did help me to not just go crazy, just mm-hmm. start all the things. Mm-hmm. Because while I don't really care about my stitching number, I'm also one of those that I don't like to let something linger. So if I want to touch everything, we've got to keep that number reasonable. Mm-hmm. So my goals, I wanted 1500 stitches on all of my projects plus any new starts, which I accomplished except for one. I have one that's not hitting its 1500 by the end of the year. And which it was one of Hinpeck that I started last month. Just because it's the 23rd.
Right. As previously discussed.
Yeah. Like if I was done with all my finishes, I could definitely hit it, but it's just not my priority. So still, I feel like that I did pretty well in that goal if I didn't complete it. I did zero out my WIPCO board, although I'm horrible about keeping up with it. But it's because those goals lined up with the just putting 1500 stitches in all my projects. So it was kind of a cheater's way of going about it.
Well, I mean, hey, go for it.
I take that back. I have one block because I put finish for Lady of the Flag instead of 1500. So I have one. that's really it. That and just trying to focus and get progress and not be quite so scattered, like here, there, and everywhere. I used to switch every single day, which I mean, I kind of still do, but I'll see the same project a few times in a month because I'm trying to hit those bigger goals.
Mm-hmm.
And next year, we're going to kind of roll into the next one, is that I'm going to do like you did in the, all my whips need at least 1,000 stitches. Anything in my oldest year, minus my hate because it's in the year before, gets 1500. And then any new starts only get 500. Cause I think had I thought about that reasonably, I would have done that last year.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Starting things right at the end of the year, you're like, there's no way.
Yeah. It's a scramble.
Yeah.
And the end of the year is always a new start time. It's always like, got to get this ready for next year. Got to have this one ready to go.
And I'm hoping to have another one before next month, but I'm struggling with fabric. So I want a specific fabric. So I don't know. I'll figure it out. All right. So your plans for next year.
Plans for next year. I am going to work on every project next year. I have some things that I haven't worked on since 2018. I'm done with that idea. I would like to at least put 3 days into everything. If that means three stitches, one on each of those 3 days, fine. That's something. At least I pulled it out to look at it. There are some projects that I forget that I have because I haven't worked on them in so long. So work on absolutely everything. I've had this thing of trying to stay at 13 or fewer new starts. So we're going to try that again. I've done it the last 2 years, no problem. So that's cool. And finish more than I start. Those are my goals.
Well, and you're particularly good at talking yourself out of things after talking yourself into them. Like, how long this year were you like, I'm going to start a full coverage any day now? And it still took me a few months, like, before you really buckled down and did it. So, I mean, at least there's that. You're not just the whimsy, oh, well, I decided, so let's go do it.
Well, I do that sometimes, but not a lot. I usually have to justify it in my own head for nobody else but myself.
It's not like your husband's going, okay, Jesse, why are we doing this?
not at all.
The other night I was stitching, I was getting to sit still and I was stitching, and my husband calls and he's like, have you had dinner yet? And I'm like, no, I don't have time. I'm trying to get this finish in. And he's like, do I need to come feed you while you stitch? And I'm like,
yes,
that is so sweet, but I'm good. I was like,
if I start shaking, then I'll go eat.
Right. And, you know, I have to, but because like the needle just won't go through. But I managed to finish 7 minutes past when I needed to be heading back. So I had to kind of, you know, be quick. But I managed it. And then I was like, well, I'll just eat while I drive. I don't know if you've ever driven a Jeep before, but that's not an option. I was like, I hit a pebble and it felt like I hit a speed bump. Gosh. The worst. I will not own a Jeep. That's not a thing.
Yeah.
Okay. So that was the truncated year in review tech. Are you planning on doing the actual year in review tech this year?
No, probably not. It's too big. It's too big.
Right. But I will link it at the end if anybody else is interested in seeing when it was created and what her answers were 6 years ago.
I think 2016. 2016? Something like that. Yeah.
Into 2015. Because it was literally right before I started doing FossTube, and I started in 2016.
Mm-hmm. Fun fact, I wrote not a single one of those questions.
I
wrote none of them. It was a community tag. I had other people ask the questions. I mean, you know, it's generic stuff, right? So for the most part. But
Because it had some neat ones that the first time you answered are really cool, and maybe even the second time if there's enough space. But then, like, if you're gonna do it every year, I'm not gonna tell you what my favorite tool is every year, because it probably hasn't changed.
Right.
Still love my little Snag Nabbit. Like, it's
still my best friend.
God's gift to stitching. So anyways, I will link it below, and that's it. So that's it. I hope y'all all have a wonderful evening, and we'll talk to y'all tomorrow. Bye. Stop it.